The key to riding an Avalanche train is preparation. I'm going to show you how throughout this virtual training series. These are proven effective techniques. I'll be sharing my 24 years of instructing experience in short segments that get right to the point. The Avalanche basics, this is what I'm looking for. Transceivers, 457 kilohertz, easy to use, digital 3 antenna, have spare batteries. How do we wear it? Well, keep it in the harness. Over one shoulder, around the waist, have it snug around the waist, that's not pulling on the shoulder. Don't have it up high. Some people have it up high so they can unzip their jacket, get to it quickly. The problem is if you bounce off the handlebars, your ribs are the weak link. Have it lower. I keep mine around the belt line, and that way if I hit the handlebars, I don't break any ribs. I can lift up my jacket, get to it quickly. Have the tether attached so you don't, if you drop the transceiver, you don't lose it. Newer transceivers with 3 antennas are more accurate. They're easier to use. Consistent numbers when you're searching, and it has features from multiple burials. When you're using Avalanche gear, keep your gloves on. All gear should be designed so you can be deployed with your gloves on. If you take your gloves off, you may forget to put them back on. So with a probe, I don't keep it in the sleeve. It's in the pack. I can pull it out. There's not that one more step to get to it. I go with a 300 centimeter probe, large diameter aluminum or carbon fiber. So I prefer the probes that are self-locking when you pull on the end. I don't want to have to take off my gloves and then screw things together. With this probe, I pull on the end, and when everything's lined up, it'll lock in place and it's fully assembled. I'll show you how it's done. I'm going to grab the one end with my left hand, I'll throw with my right, and then the right hand will grab the knob. I'll step back, I'll shake the probe and pull on the end. I like a probe with the depth markings. If I'm doing a transceiver search, I get my lowest number. Let's say it's 1.2 meters. Well, that's 120 centimeters. Hey, I think I have it. I'm gonna probe right there. Hey, about around 120 centimeters down, it feels a little soft. That's most likely the person. Leave the probe in place. If you're worried that you may have hit something else, take an additional probe and go off to the side and see if it goes deeper. But to confirm where you should dig. With a shovel, look for one with an extendable handle. Strong materials. The shoveling technique, chop, don't pry. Use your core muscles. Use it like a canoe paddle. We're chopping across, we're going in, and we're twisting using our core muscles rather than just your arm muscles. Here's your tip of the day. Buy a good shovel. The weak spot on most shovels is where the shaft attaches to the blade. A lot of blades have a neck on it. The shaft only goes in so far and then it flexes and it can bend or break easily. So we're gonna show you a demonstration here. This is a $20 shovel. Avalanche debris is extremely dense. You're chopping, you're pulling. We're gonna show you why you don't want a $20 shovel. You go to pry, that blade is useless. It'll bend. Another weak spot is right here. This just failed on you. You're in the backcountry. What are you going to do to dig right now? Your hands aren't effective. It's like trying to dig through this table. That's another reason I carry two shovels and I only buy quality shovels. Let's talk about shovel location. If you only have one shovel, it always goes on your pack. And the reason being is, if your sled gets buried in an avalanche or you get separated from your sled, you always have your shovel, you have your rescue gear in your pack, you can pull off a rescue. If you have an airbag pack or you have an airbag vest, I actually carry two shovels. And the reason being is I can be quicker in rescue if I don't have to take off the pack to get the shovel. I also get to keep the safety of the airbag pack with me. So, I have a shovel on my tunnel bag, and I like to have a hoe-shaped shovel on the tunnel bag. I jump off the sled, I pull the shovel out, and I'm ready to rescue. I have my transceiver right here, I can go rescue. So here's the airbag vest I wear. I'm gonna show you where I keep things and what I carry with me. I have my radio right here. It has a smart mic so I can control the volume right here, the channels, push to talk. In my front pocket is my transceiver. It's attached to a D-ring. Easy access for quicker rescues and for doing transceiver checks at the beginning of the day. In the front here is a D-ring. I can put my snowmobile tether, external shovel carry. Other people can pull it out of my pack. And then within the pack, I have the essentials to spend the night out, do first aid, and pull off a rescue. Avalanche probe. This is a tow system to pull out sleds. Wrap, CPR mask, first aid kit, wood saw for fires, also getting the sled out of tree wells. I have water, I have extra food, I have extra gloves, I have extra layers. This is a snow saw for doing stability tests. I have a map, first aid bandages, a bivy sack. This is in case you have to spend the night out or someone's injured. You can put someone in this. It's like a space blanket that's shaped like a sleeping bag. Keeps the heat in. One main thing is get that person up off the snow with tree boughs so they're not getting cold from the snow. I have a compass. This is a SAM splint. It's a flexible splint. You can work it in many different ways. I have a Siloam stick, glow stick. I have heat packs. There's a base unit of my battery. I have a carabiner. There's the probe. And then this pocket here, extra batteries, headlamp, GPS satellite messenger. This is the only reliable way to get help to your location. Cell phones, I never rely on them in the backcountry. The batteries go dead in the cold, and many places where I ride, there's no cell service. No one ever plans their accidents. Hopefully nothing does happen. If it does happen, you have the gear. One thing that's in here I forgot to mention is a fire starter, having different ways to start a fire. That is your key to surviving a night out, is being able to start a fire and have plenty of firewood, have a couple of good saws. I have one in the shaft of my shovel on my tunnel bag, and I have multiple ways to start a fire. If you'd like more high quality avalanche training for free, go to backcountryascender.com. Take an on-snow class to learn how to rescue effectively. The most common factor in snowmobile avalanche fatalities in the last 5 years in the United States has been lack of advanced training. Remember, this series is a great start to what you need to know, but level one requires an on-snow course, and that's where you'll experience the best train evaluation lessons. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll have much more information next episode. Get your riding partners to watch. Here's some links to win prizes and learn more.